The day he was made Pope, the internet was full of images of the two of us side by side. It was either me and the Pope or High Sparrow and the Pope, which led to a lot of speculation that maybe I was in fact the Pope and it was my latest role. So there was a kind of inevitability to it.
Okay. What was your first reaction when they call you to the Pope Francis?
I've mixed feelings. Pope Francis is really the first Pope that I've really been aware of. I mean, I'm not Roman Catholic, I'm not religious, but he was the first Pope that was saying things that meant something to me and people like me who had concerns about the environment and about social issues. I was very happy to do it once I read the script. Of course, the thing that really clinched it was that Fernando was going to be directing it.
Did you know Fernando before?
No, I knew. City of God is one of my favorite all-time films. I never thought that I would have the opportunity to work with Fernando. And as you know, he's a wonderful director.
Yeah, it's fantastic.
Yeah.
I know it's very early, but we can have some pizza.
Of course.
Yeah. I'm going to count 1, 2, 3, and
okay.
I'm going to have a pizza.
Wow.
We have with cebolla, it is fugaceta, and mozzarella. A very sophisticated
Fanta.
Drink. Fanta.
Yeah. Pope Benedict's favorite.
Yeah. But
so I know how I felt when I was asked to play Pope Francis, because there's a distance between me and Argentina, and I could be an outsider looking in. What kind of responsibility do you think you were carrying by playing him? Did you worry that you would be portraying one side of him?
Well, before I read the script, I thought this might be, everything beautiful about Bergoglio, and he's a great Pope, and he's this guy who always smiles. But once I read the script, I realized that pretty much everything that I thought about the Argentinian history was there, and the movie really doesn't evade anything. No. It would have been a pity for me to work in something that I don't really believe.
You're mistaken. You are
silence. I cannot play this role anymore.
When I see you two, you and Anthony working together, it's so amazing. I mean, everybody said the two of them, they're so great.
I was nervous about working with him. He's a bit of a hero of mine.
What was the first time?
Yeah, well, we'd both been on a recording of the Dylan Thomas poem, but that was like almost 30 years ago. You know about it, but we have this thing called a call sheet, which tells you what time you're working the next day, what scenes you're doing, and it has your name and your character. And it also has a number next to it, which denotes your importance to the film. And this time round, I was number one and Tony was number two. It sort of rankled a bit with him. He's not used to being number two. So every morning at breakfast or every morning arriving at work, he'd greet me with, morning, number one. And I'd say, morning, number two. And he had huge signs made for his trailer that were bigger than mine. And he tried to get number one put on his trailer. But he'd get his revenge because after we finished filming and we'd be exchanging emails, he would say, morning, number one, and he'd sign off yours, sir, number two. So he'd get his own back on that.
It's great that many things of the movie were shot at the real location.
The strongest memory I have is saying Mass, which was a very moving time. They were very excited. A couple of times, young women brought their babies to be blessed.
Oh, really?
By me. And they were either thinking I was the Pope or pointing at me and saying Perón.
Yeah, because you did Perón and the Pope Francis.
Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah, there's some left.
Yeah, we have Maradona.
Maradona, I'm a bit too tall. But,
no, but we with CGI, they can do everything
course.
Now.
Yeah.
Don't worry.
Yeah.
And Messi, you can do Messi too.
Yeah. Yeah, my skills are up there with his.
Absolutely, yeah. I think so.
If you do this, you will damage the papacy forever.
I was wondering if you saw like a lot of YouTube videos of Pope Francis.
When he was made Pope, there were lots of coverage about him on TV. I had a great awareness of how he moved and spoke. It was just the softness of tone and the kind of gentleness in his voice. There was things I discovered about him that I don't walk like him, he walks like me. So I think he's actually been looking at my old movies and researching the way I walk.
Did you speak Italian before?
No, I didn't, I didn't speak Spanish and I didn't speak Italian and certainly not Latin. I mean, I only learned what I had to say.
Yeah.
So my papal Spanish is perfect, but I still couldn't order a meal in a restaurant. But I could say mass.
Is there at least a possibility that you might be chosen?
No.
It could never be me.
And when I read the script, I didn't know it was as funny as it is. When I've seen it with audiences, and it was a real surprise how much they laughed. That laughter is an indication that they're really listening.
Did you improvise a lot?
It looks like improvisation.
Yeah.
Nearly everything was in the script. We get to tango together.
And what about that scene? It was written that you were supposed to dance?
It was scripted, but we didn't rehearse it. So I just went into it to teach him how to dance. And I don't know how good a dancer Tony is. He's not very good at doing the tango. I know that much. It's an indication of where that relationship has gone. You know, the two guys looking beadily at each other during the first conclave, to becoming two men who could tango together. And also the way that, you know, I went to say goodnight to him early in the film and go to embrace him, and he shifts it to very awkward.
Yeah, that tells a lot.
He doesn't even go for a man hug. And at the end of the film, towards it, I'm giving all the ends away now, but everybody knows what happens. They're still alive. There is a very warm and meaningful embrace, which I know people find very moving.
Yeah, very much, yeah.
Sir Rigano, your gardener gave it to me.
You're very popular.
I just try to be myself.
Whenever I try to be myself, people don't seem to like me very much.
Well, we've been talking too much. Now you can see the movie and you can comment to tell us what you think.
Yeah, answers on a postcard, please.